Hey, welcome back. Today I am going to be talking a little bit about pores. I just really felt inclined to do this video because I think that pores are still marketed, especially in the cosmetic industry, as being a nuisance. And I just wanted to talk about pores in general because I feel like a lot of people don't understand how pores and makeup work together. And I think that a lot of products made in the past several years have really preyed upon a lot of people's insecurities with their pores. And I just wanted to do a little chat about that. And then I am also going to show you a really simple process that you can take some really simple products if you do feel insecure about your pores, if you have enlarged pores and it's just something that you want to address in your daily makeup routine. I actually brought my friend in. A lot of you all are saying, please like show me, this, and this on different skin or on this particular skin type. So I brought my friend in. She was in for the day, and I just kind of show you some products that I personally love that will help to minimize the look of pores if it is something that you're just not a fan of in general. So that's what we're gonna do today. Let's go ahead and get into it. Every single person on this planet, even the people you look at on Instagram that seem like they have angelic skin that absolutely has no pores, no texture to it, they have texture, whether it's being edited out or it's just extremely small texture. We all have texture to the skin. So just let it be known that texture and pores in general, very normal. So this is kind of where I want to get into the makeup aspect of things and something that I wanted to address for those of you who are maybe continuously buying products that make the claim that they're gonna make your pores vanish or disappear. I'm just gonna put this as plain and simple as possible. I've talked about this in previous videos, but you cannot cover a pore. You cannot physically cover a pore because it is an indentation. It is a textured area in the skin. And just if you think about it, like for those of you who may get Botox or fillers, what are you getting those procedures for? You're getting them to fill areas in on the face. And the best way I can put this into terms for you, name one foundation that can actually fill your skin. I'll wait. Foundations, concealers, they cannot cover pores. They can only go on top of pores. And unfortunately, most of the time, they end up just emphasizing those areas. So what I wanted to do today is give you this really simple three-step process, share some products with you that if pores are something that do bother you, they are of a concern to you. These are three products and just a little three-step technique, three-step method that I think is just a really good combination to distract or minimize the appearance. I also brought my friend in because a lot of you all are saying like, oh, I wish you would do this on different skin. So I brought my friend in to kind of show you these products in action. So first product, and probably the most crucial product if you do have enlarged pores, is finding a good pore-filling primer. Primers, which is very ironic because I know most of you are watching, know that I don't personally use primer on really any type of basis. I use my skincare as primer, but if you do have more porous or textured skin, they can make a world of difference, and specifically the ones that were formulated to actually fill. And so those are generally like the silicone-based primers. The one that I have here today is one of my all-time favorites. It's the Makeup Forever Smoothing Primer. Also really enjoy the Smashbox Pore Minimizing Primer, the one that is in the purple tube. These work incredibly well, and I did a little demo on my friend showing her before. And then during the process, you can see the primer actually filling and smoothing in those areas, and by the end, it's almost as if the pores aren't even there. And so that's why I think products like these are very effective and probably one of the most important steps in your routine for minimizing textured areas. So second recommendation falls underneath your foundation, and I cannot stress this enough. Throw all of your full coverage matte foundations in the garbage. The thicker your foundation formula and the more pigmented your foundation formula, the more likely it is to emphasize the porous areas. We've already addressed that you can't physically cover pores. And so my recommendation is actually looking into a formula that is thinner in texture. If you want to learn more about the textures of foundations, I will have that video linked down below where I talk about all the different textures and foundation formulas and which ones are best for particular skin types. But in general, for more porous skin, using something that is a little bit more thinner and water-based, that way the pigment and just the overall texture of the product isn't going to be seeping into the pores and enhancing those areas. A great example, and I know I sound like a broken record, is MAC Face and Body. Phenomenal formula if you do have more porous skin. I kind of did a comparison side by side on my friend's skin where one side I used a thicker, full coverage, more matte foundation on her, and then on the other side I use MAC Face and Body, and I think you can tell a major difference in how it looks. Even she looked at her face in the mirror and she was like, wow, the side that I put the more fuller coverage matte on, she was like, this kind of makes me look like I'm 5 to 6 years older. So I'll have some foundation recommendations down below, especially for all skin types. You can find thinner formulas that have a matte finish. You can find thinner formulas that have more of a luminous. Just try to stay away from those that are kind of like marketed as instant coverage and full coverage matte. You know, those types of foundations that are just notoriously meant to immediately cover the skin, not going to end up looking the best if you have textured skin. So lastly, we're going to talk about powders, and the same thing really goes for powders as I mentioned with foundations. If you're using a powder that is kind of like a powder foundation slash touch-up powder combo, or is meant to be a thicker powder formula, you can't really layer those throughout the day and reapply without them looking heavier on the skin and ultimately without them emphasizing porous areas. So my suggestion is to just find a really good smoothing translucent powder, especially if you're combination oily. You can touch up with those throughout the day. I'm not going to give one particular recommendation because there are so many translucent powders on the market, and I feel like obviously one that works for one person isn't going to work for the next. I do enjoy the Laura Mercier translucent powder. I think it's a good universal one, but just using that to set the areas will really just help smooth. It's not going to emphasize and keep adding product on top of the skin. And again, ultimately, if you need to touch up throughout the day for more combination areas, it's going to set much nicer than using a baked powder, a powder foundation, or even just a general pressed powder. So that's pretty much it. Pretty practical approach. Most of you all probably already have these products in your collection. I just wanted to do this because I still get comments saying like, ooh, which foundation is best to cover pores? And there just isn't one. And if you do feel self-conscious about having pores or texture on your skin, just know that everybody has texture. I have 5 chickenpox scars on my face. And what's funny is I always notice them, but then in videos, people are like, what are you talking about? So just know people aren't looking at your skin at a microscopic level, and most of the time what you're seeing in ads and especially on Instagram, 10 out of 10 have been edited. So long live the pores. Pores are not the enemy, and I hope if you do have some areas of concern on your skin regarding pores, that this little process and some of these recommendations can help you out. So hope you enjoyed, and I'll see y'all in my next video. Bye.